Greetings, and welcome back to Dark Souls 3. I have already kitted myself up for the poison in this swampy area, and I believe that what I seek is off to our left. Yes, in this area full of trees. You can just see him move off to the left there. I did anyway. And we've got a couple of shinies, some Gru. There he is. Yes, I came here with my character that I have playing on the side just for funsies without recording, because I need more Dark Souls 3 in my life than just what I can get while I'm recording. I really have the other great side of the most of the stuff in the swamp is bleeding, so I'm just risking my own bleeding for no good purpose. Yes. Well, I was fighting one Gru, and he stuck up on me, and then another Gru came up and he killed me. Seen all of the ice items, but we're picking them up for the first time, okay. Well, that reminds me, when I came here, I was going to see if I could get him over there and have the giant archer assist me. If what I got from the wiki when I was reading about him was correct, then anywhere that has a tree like this, he will aid you if you have befriended him. And I have. I am sad. I forgot that that was something I resolved to do, and, you know, check it out. On the other hand, more of these. I find it interesting that Dust's crown is over here, but her armor kit is way over there. Somebody clearly looted this place, despite the giant's protection. I'm curious. That can't be Goth, can it? I mean, it sounds like the blacksmith from, Dark Souls 1, the giant blacksmith who takes care of lightning weapons, crystal weapons, and all that nonsense, but, you know, that could just be limited voice acting resources they couldn't afford to just have a new one for every new character. So they reused somebody who was available, but... Ooh, shiny. Huh. I will always take a free piece of materials. Now then, the next important thing that I discovered while I was playing for funsies must be done from a different bonfire than this one. Onwards. Since we're done with the poison, time to look stylish. Yes. Fashion souls, eh? Here we are! The perimeter bonfire. I discovered something quite interesting when I was here farming the Black Knight with my other character. Step forth to trigger the area loading, and then sit back and watch with glory. Go Team Dark Wraiths! I'm your biggest fan! Fuck 'em up! This is amazing place to farm because you've got... God, they're vicious. They even go for the guy who's just sitting off to the side. That happens consistently. Anyway, this place is amazing for farming because you can get the Dark Wraith kit and the Black Knight's kit. Because the Black Knight drops his shield, his weapon, and his entire armor set. And the Black Knight and the Dark Wraith do the same. I don't think they drop the Dark Hand on account of the fact that it sells for such a tidy, tidy profit for the, Our Lord and Hollow Lady. Yuria, I think it is? I don't know. But yeah, one of them will usually die. Not always, because they're fairly vicious. But they will take care of everyone on the way to this boss. And this has definitely got to be a boss. There's no way this is not a boss. Shit! Get out of there. That is not my Estus. Huh, I didn't actually expect that to stagger him. Now I got him! I wish I knew if there was some kind of sound effect or special visual that would tell me when I have successfully gotten the headshot. Like I think I did just there. Because I suddenly did 140 damage instead of the usual 70-ish average. Of course, scythes are fairly complicated now, because in the previous game, I think it already contained the mechanic, Dark Souls 1 I'm talking about now, that if you hit things with the farthest end of the blade, instead of up close near the hilt here, it would do more damage. I'm fairly certain that they wouldn't have gotten rid of that mechanic. Deputy Guts, ally required ahead, or pure luck. Yeah, y'all needed man up. Most things can be taken care of alone. Yep, I was correct. Boss. What boss, though? Is this the Legion? Because clearly, I am already in this covenant. Yeah, that looks like a cutscene. And they are infighting. Also, ow. Abyss Watcher. Plural. That's not a good sign. Nice, like Artorias. And I don't think I can backstab. Let's try a couple more times. Ah, shit. That's what I was afraid of with the plural. There's more than one of them. That ember. Right, so, be quick, be vicious. Don't give him time to stand up. And if my guess is correct, I assume that killing them takes care of the boss health meter, not hitting them, because that when I punched that one guy, he didn't really detract any damage from the boss HP bar. So it is very much a focus on killing them, not on damaging them. You don't have time to stand around and whittle away at them. You need to... You know what? I bet I could just let the Dark Wraiths handle this. Run off along the side. Kill the one guy they don't kill. Pick that up, Roily. You know, let's just assume that I'm going to need to be faster than I currently am. Bring my sword to this fight. I know there's a couple more Gruul over here, but since the Dark Wraiths have taken care of the Vanguard up front, We'll just mosey on past here. Excuse me, guys. Have fun fighting the Dark Wraith. I'll be in here. Oh no, this is just, this one guy has the soul of them all, I guess. And he can be stun locked by a lava sword. That is very pathetic. Shit! God, they get you on the ground and they pin you down. I was slamming the roll button there and I still didn't get anything. Oh! Oh! They are really fighting themselves amongst themselves, aren't they? They can damage each other. Are they all just perpetually fighting over the Lord of the Soul? Like, the Lord's Soul? God, what is it called now? Soul of a Lord of Cinder? Like, are they all just fighting to be the guy that's holding it now? Yeah, fuck it. The Dark Race will take care of it. Take care of it faster if I get them to aggro on me and then run past me. Me, pardon me, coming through, guys. Have fun with the Dark Wraith. Hi, guys. Wait, that was a backstab animation. Well, he can be backstabbed, it's just not hard. Ones that aren't the boss will fight amongst each other. Nope, they'll hurt the boss, alright. And just kind of fucking pathetic at it. Yeah, that's definitely a backstab enemy. Fucking man. And this is easy. With them fighting amongst each other, I don't know why anybody would have a problem with this. They're fucking doing my job for me. Unless, of course, I have to finish them all off once I hold the soul. Also, I screwed up there by being too aggressive. Oh, come on! What is this nonsense? You know, I wonder, these guys seem like they would definitely be vulnerable to bleed, so let's go ahead and give the scythe another shot. Unequip the sword for the weight purposes. Should prioritize having some melee defense. I don't think they have any kind of damage type. They look like they're wielding weapons that would just be regular damage. Like, just literally the damage type regular, instead of slash. We'll leave the pants as it is, and we'll rely solely on the power of the armor of Sunbeam. Or specifically, the lack thereof, because Solaire didn't have power beyond his own swordsmanship training. He was just that awesome. And a great guy to boot. He really should have gotten to find his own son. Would have met a better sun god than Gwyn, I bet. Excuse me, guys, pardon me, coming through. That's all with the Dark Raids. Huh, I didn't actually think the that roll was going to work, but it did. Come on! Maybe I should grab my souls and homeward bone out, because having to try and focus on picking them up for the first segment of the fight is really not going in my favor. On the other hand, this being such a clear-cut, you can run past it thing with the dark rays covering your retreat, or advance, I suppose. Never let it be said that the dark rays couldn't be a bro every now and then. Know that I was getting a backstab there. I was just trying to, Why does the Snipe have less poise break than the goddamn longsword? Who thought that that was a good idea? The thing is fucking huge. Really, whoever thought... I mean, the Scythe is literally doing about the exact same base damage as a longsword, but it swings in a slightly slower, slightly more awkward manner. And it doesn't have the amount of heft on staggering opponents that are hit with it that a longsword does? This is bullshit. Hell, I knew it. That was gonna happen eventually. It is not my manner to just dash past one. God damn it. Go, 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 go! Souls. Oh yeah, the dark race of killing guys outside the front gate now. Amazing combos. If they're channeling Artorias' soul, I mean, he was unmatched with a greatsword, they said. God damn it. I am not good at dashing. dash attack they have is fucking savage. He falls down and gets no souls, so I'm wasting my time when I kill them. They're just gonna keep getting back up. Same time, I'm gonna get them off my ass. You got back up already? Yeah, this is definitely wasting my time. I wasted them to start fighting amongst each other. Hell, if I wait long enough, maybe they'll just kill him for me. Although it'll take a while. I'm kind of worried about how many of them can get up. How are all three of you gonna fit on that throne? I mean, it's big, but it's not that big. Excuse me, Molly, be a pretty shirt bag here. Focus on back step.
Headshot!
Fuck yeah, that was a headshot! Well, that was a great way to end that fight. And now he is the true Lord of Cinder, I think. Yeah, that is definitely modeled after Artorias' sword. Don't recognize the dagger, though. Oh, no, wait, that's modeled after Kieran's dagger. Kieran? Lord's Blade Kieran. And now the real fight begins. I hope it's just the one guy now, though. I much prefer fights like that. Oh, the fuck is it? There he is. I could probably still backstab it though. Oh yeah, he's actually doing fire damage, but because I have a good fire block shield, no big deal. Fucking hell, he takes the stamina though. Even block right now. I wasted way too much essence on the first pass of this fight, but I didn't know that there was gonna be a second pass, damn it. Okay, so I can still stagger him, but it's just fucking savage, so it's hard. Get out of stamina. Fuck the bleed. There is no opportunity that I'm going to be able to get bleed on him with a slow-ass scythe. Back to the Lothric sword, I guess. I'm really starting to see the criticism that I keep hearing whenever I go to touch the online community. Even as brief a touch as I usually do, because, you know, spoilers, and I don't want them. That just says that, oh yeah, just grab a longsword and start punching shit. That's all you need to do. Best weapon in the game is just a longsword. Fucking basic. And that makes me sad because the new stupid tracking attacks. Anyway, because the new sites really excite me. Like, they seem really cool, but they're just too slow, too awkward. God damn. I can't even get my souls like this. And now I'm backing myself into the wall and setting myself to be up. Ambushed from behind by one of the guys getting up. Alright guys, get up, get up, get up. Fight up amongst yourselves now. I don't need to use any more Estus on this bullshit. That's more like it. Come on, over here. Nope, not me, not me, not me. Them, come on. Amongst yourselves, goddammit. Oh, that's why, okay. When they do that dash and spin thing, it kind of fucks with what you're facing. I'll fight you. Come on. While your friend's busy. I'll keep it coming. They do that, they spin around backwards, so it seems they don't actually slide. Oh, I just inherited some energy from the guy dying outside. That seems great. Hey, what, that main guy is fucking savage for damage. Got behind my shield. I just don't know a good way to speed this fight up without getting the two of them to fight each other. Okay, turn and look at each other now, please. No, 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 no! Don't all three of you be looking at me. Okay, this is a check. What I should be looking out for is getting out of the way of the swing with the greatsword, blocking that dagger attack. Because every time I block the dagger attack, it takes to knock them off balance. Here we go again. The ass one just backstab fish and spike death. Definitely want to get out of the way of that attack. Covers his own ass with that. Nice try. I saw that he was trying to roll out of the way at that time. Quite so bad if those flames were, you know, those swaths of flames talking and fighting. Those swaths of flame that he keeps spitting out didn't have their own separate field dagger animation. Because all of his attacks because that use that flame attack trigger you your shield bouncing twice and really screw with when you think you're going to attack and when you're actually still just kind of pinned down for a split second. Really? I just finished him by staggering him with a long sword. Cinders of a Lord, soul of the blood of the wolf. So, the whole wolf's blood thing was just uniting all of their souls to the Lord's soul. Whatever. Can I have me some of that? Oh, wait, what? This is an unusual elevator. Or door. Door works too. I can't have me some of the wolf's blood? God damn it. What do we got here? I'm kind of out of time, so I don't really have the opportunity to explore this. But, new area, and I am very much out of time and overtime. 32,000 souls means a couple of level ups, maybe buying some shit. But, we beat a boss! Took me a couple of tries, but not that hard, really. Given that the first half of the fight, they're fighting amongst themselves. And in the second half of the fight, he's, well, kind of like Lord Gwyn, really. Some kind of half-hybrid between Lord Gwyn and Artorias from Dark Souls 1. And with my fire block and shield, that's not really a problem. Now, Grant, I could have opted for the 4% extra block of fire damage, but since I wasn't taking much fire damage anyway, the extra stability was far more important. Okay, then. I think that's all for this episode, folks. We killed a boss. A Lord of Cinders boss. So, I hope you all have a great day. See you next time. Bye-bye.